Game time! Game time, baby! Let's go! Let's go!
Get ready for College Hoops 2K8. The Purdue Boilermakers battle the Ohio State Buckeyes. We're really excited to bring you this matchup. Hello, basketball fans. We're here at Value City Arena. This is Vern Lundquist with Bill Raftery and Tracy Wolfson. Give us your take, Bill.
The story here is the matchup at off guard. Stevanovic is a wonderfully talented shooting guard. I love his offensive awareness. He knows how to manipulate defenders and really gets in their heads. Dux is an excellent shooting guard in his own right. He's a gunner from long range, and that really opens up things for his teammates. Both looking to lead their teams to a win. We'll see who succeeds.
Purdue wins the tip-off, and the game is underway. Beats it to the free throw line. Comfortable. And it's controlled by Ohio State.
A little too much activity down there, and he forgot to squeeze it. Always protect the ball, Vern.
Last basket on the mark by Rivello. Menard inbounds the ball. Rowland. Dishes it to the strike. The crossover releases from 16 feet. It was nailed by Menard. And it's now a tie ball game. Let's check in with our sideline reporter, Tracy Wolfson, who has some info for us.
Vern, earlier today I talked with the Buckeyes coach. He told me that they want to use their quickness to their advantage. He said they couldn't think of another squad that could match their team's speed. And he wants to make sure that shows tonight by getting out on the break and showing how fast this game can be played. Guys?
Thanks, Tracy. Roller catches it on the free throw line. Stipes yanks it down inside. Ohio State kept on falling behind big in the early rounds, but each time they fought back and eventually went to the title game.
It really says something about a team's character when they're able to come back so many times, especially in a tournament setting.
Menard inbounds the ball. High post. Nice pass. The 11-footer was good by Ducks. But they're still down by three. Just over 8 minutes left in the half. Last shot dumped down by Sykes. Too many holes in the fence, Bill.
All you need is one to go down, and then boom!
Ducks. Cuts off the pass.
Not a good entry pass, Vern. You just can't force it in there.
Finishes in close. He's got two. Hamilton inbounds the ball. The Buckeyes were the last ones to touch it, and they'll turn it over.
That's not the kind of teamwork you like to see out there. They need to get on the same page.
Rivello
fought for that rebound. That's some toughness for you.
Stipes takes it up. Up and in off the bench. They bring their lead to seven.
They're set up in minute.
Passes it to the left. Crosses it up. The shot was short by Rowland.
He can't be happy with that miss. With all the room he had, he's got to make that shot.
Leads him with the pass. Rowland uses the glass and it goes in. And they're now behind by five. Lock up.
Lovello throws it up. Knocks it down from 3-point line. By 8. Swings it to the wing. Lead pass to the paint. Frazier grabs the rock.
It's still early, Vern, but they can't take any more time to get this thing going. It hasn't been pretty for them so far.
No good on that last shot by Stevanović. Goes up. Frazier is going to be hit with the blocking foul. That's his first foul.
Well, he got there in time. It looked like he was leaning when the contact occurred.
Menard inbounds the ball. Dickerson unloads. Menard snatches the offensive rebound. That last shot offline from 20.
The fadeaway can get you extra separation, but he had plenty of room anyway. The Purdue coach might have decided to switch things up a little bit. He's going to take time to make sure everybody's clear on the game plan.
Knocks it loose, but it's tracked down by Melville. Samuel corrals the miss inside. Flipped it up and out.
His team really needs him to hit that.
Frazier dishes it to the right side. Gets it to go, and he's got a chance to add one more.
Beautiful work to fight through that foul and get to the line for the 3 opportunity.
Good for the 3-point play. Owen inbounds the ball. Right wing, ducks to end the run, hits it. But they're still behind by 10. They're going to double team him. Under 5 minutes left in the half. Bounces it to the left side. Pulls the trigger. Snatched inside by Menard. It's 1-on-1. Melville goes up. Lays it right in. They cut the lead to 8. It's deflected, but it's recovered by Ohio State. The Buckeyes will retain possession. Off the inbound, swish through by Frazier. They're up 23-13.
Cut.
Hamilton pulls it in.
Might have rushed that one just a little bit. There was plenty of time on the shot clock, but he got a little over anxious.
But 3, and it's scooped up by Ducks. Great anticipation and quick hand.
It's a deuce the other way if you don't protect the basketball.
Passes it back to the wing. That last basket was buried by Owens.
You have to keep your head up and eyes open at all times playing with this guy.
That's right, and you never know when or where he'll find it.
Oh, that was not a good look. It wasn't about the defensive pressure either. He just fired it off target.
Gibbs inbounds the ball. Purdue has had serious problems with their interior defense. And Tracy has a report from their bench.
The Boilermakers coach is definitely aware of that problem. He told his assistants that they have to bring more defenders into the paint, even if it means leaving the perimeter open. Desperate measures here, Vern.
Thanks, Tracy. About 3.5 minutes left in the half. Frazier passes it up court. Frazier releases, gets the 3-pointer to go. They now lead by 9. Picks it up. Stipes corrals the miss off a nice box out. 2:56 left in the first half. Goes up. Beautiful rebound. Boxed his man out and never let him regain position. He's got 2. Melville to the rim, slides in with a soft finger roll. They're now behind by 9.
Here comes the full court press here. They're trying to create some turnover.
The Buckeyes turn this one over out of bounds.
I'm not sure who that was going to, Vern. It seems he hit the panic button and sent the ball sailing.
Feeds, high post, rolling. From 17 feet out, hits right rim and doesn't fall.
Roller is having a hard time getting his shot to go, Vern. You just hope it doesn't wreck his confidence. It's hard to see how it would.
Catches it in the paint. Kidd lays it up and in. But they're still down by 10. Allen inbounds the ball. The Buckeyes will retain possession. Both teams are going to make some substitutions.
Boy, what a good deflection. He didn't get the steal, but he's still disrupting the offense.
.155 left in the first half. Ravello skips it to the right. Terrific swat. Big time rejection.
It seems like nothing can destroy this guy, but he will destroy you in a heartbeat.
Left. Let it go from the left block. It's one-on-one. Fires the three. Drilled by Shea. They're now up by 15.
These people aren't loving it. You think it's getting louder here or what?
Feeds it to the wing.
On it from the baseline.
Ravello corrals it, and that's his fifth rebound in this one. Leads him in. Takes it up. The lay-in was good by Lambert. 5:15.
Roller picks it up.
Stipes pulls it in. The Buckeyes bring it up the court. They're on a 13-4 run. Last 15 points by Hamilton.
Irrepressible, Vern. These guys just keep coming after you.
We've seen no let up, that's for sure.
On it.
Griffin dumps it off. Manoa has it. Right foot. Off target on the last layup. 30 seconds left in the first half.
I love the defense. Just because he's in tight doesn't mean you have to give up the easy deuce.
Fisher, top of the key. Stipes. Stolen away by Purdue.
I like how he gets himself into defensive position.
At the right place, right time yet again. Perfect shot by Arnold. He's got two. With the shot. The offensive board gathered by Sykes. First half comes to an end with the score 38-23. What's your take on the first half, Bill?
Well, I don't want to rule out the possibility of a comeback.
We're all set to begin the second half. Hamilton inbounds it to start the second half. Now let's go down to Tracy Wolfson, who has an update for us.
Well, at halftime, I talked with the Buckeyes coach. He felt it wouldn't be classy to run up the score and was going to change things in a way to make sure that doesn't happen. Coach said that even though his starters had plenty of energy, he would still rotate in his bench players. He said that it wasn't a question of fatigue, but more of a method of showing different looks on offense. Back to you.
All right, Tracy. We'll see if they can do that. Leads him with the pass. Dickerson banks it in. He's 1-for-2 for the game. Frazier puts it up. It's blocked. Let's it go. The shot inside, rained by Hamilton. He's shooting 100% for the game. Dickerson with the teardrop. Dickerson snatches it down inside. Finished nicely down low on that last shot.
No way he was coming up empty when he got the ball that close to the rim.
Last shot laid in by Ravello. Here, inbounds the ball. Roller has had some difficulties. Frazier, way up court. The Boilermakers with some difficulties. Bounces it to the right wing. Menard finishes in close. They now trail by 14. Stipes has it inside. Open look. Bricks it off the back of the rim. But they're still up by 14. Stevanovich is tagged with the reach, and that's his first foul of the game. Both teams are going to shake things up a little bit with some subs. Well, let's get back to the action. Ivan inbounds the ball. And he's his team's leading scorer. Frazier with the full court line. The Buckeyes were the last ones to touch it, and they'll turn it over.
Oh, Vern, they've got to communicate a little bit better out there so they don't have any more passes like that one.
Just over 7 minutes left in the second half. Catches it, left wing. Rowan beats it to the top of the key. Couldn't get the shot, but he was fouled and gets tripped around. He makes the first. Gets them both. Hamilton inbounds the ball. Ohio State is shooting itself in the foot with all the turnovers. Tracy has something for us.
The Buckeyes coach is not sugarcoating the issue. He told his assistants our fundamentals are abysmal. And then added the only players I want on the floor right now are the ones that can take care of the ball.
All right, Tracy.
The wrong time to start missing your free throws, Vern. They sure would like to fan their lead.
Dickerson, nice little crossover. Left wing, shoots it. The lead is cut to single digits by Roland. He's 1-for-3 from downtown. Samuel takes the shot. Can't put an end to the run. They still have a 7-point lead. Last 13 point was missed by Dallas. Flip up and in on that last layup.
Uses the teardrop. And oh, what a move, Vern.
Here comes the double team. Knocked loose. But it's retrieved by Rivello. Owen inbounds the ball. The Boilermakers with some difficulties.
Stolen by Frazier. You've got to squeeze it. You need to do a very good job of protecting the ball there. What a pass. Tipped away.
And it's picked up by Purdue. Picked him clean.
Well, the game just slows down for him to the point he sees things that others don't. The Purdue coach made some changes that could affect their chemistry a little bit. I don't think these guys have played together very often.
Gives it to the right side. Menard gets the jumper. They narrow it to 5. Frazier throws the pass offline and it heads out of bounds.
That's just a loss of concentration. You gotta pick your spot and hit the target. You just can't fling the ball.
Menard inbounds the ball. Dumps it down low. Stipes gets the board inside. The break is on. He attacked it with everything he had, but it still wasn't enough.
Good defense, not playing with Shannon Hart.
That last shot was blown by Stevanovic. Just over 5 minutes left in the second half.
There's no question what kind of defense the rebound did with.
Bounce pass, top of the key. Goes up. Pulled in by Lambert.
There's nothing he can do but shake his head on that one and move on.
Frazier. Got it. He's shooting 80% from deep. Purdue is really struggling. Purdue calls time. And getting set to inbound the ball. Menard inbounds the ball. Gets it. Left wing. It was hit by Ducks. But they're still behind by 7. They're bringing the double team. Lambert passes it up court. Stipes goes up. He gets hammered. And he'll head to the stripe. He misses the first. Both teams are going to make some substitutions. Good on number 2. Both teams will make some substitutions.
Purdue wants more experience out on the floor, and they're bringing on the senior.
Gibbs inbounds the ball. Just over 4 minutes left in the second half. Crosses it over. Melvin swings it to the right wing. Fires. Holding by Rivello. And that's his 6th rebound of the game.
The defense couldn't have left him any more wide open. Were they ever lucky?
Menard brings it up the floor. Ducks hands it off. Left wing. Dishes to the left block. The crossover. They rule this one goaltender. Count the shot. Onan is needed out on the floor. He didn't get much of a rest. Hamilton tosses it up. Nothing but net. They're in front, 57-49. The Boilermakers all time. Melvin is back in the game after a short rest. Menard inbounds the ball. The crossover. Dickerson goes up. Slides in with a soft finger roll. He's got 8. Stevanovic, the leader, just missed it. No 3-point opportunity. He'll go to the line for 2. He gets it! Hunter got a quick reader, but they need him back on the floor. Ball as well. Melvin didn't sit for long, and he's coming back into the ballgame. Purdue is really struggling. Ducks. Pulls the trigger. It's money from deep. 17 points, and he leads all scorers. Hamilton inbounds the ball. Frazier way up court. It goes out of bounds.
They were just out of sync on that one. The pass went one way, and he went the other.
2:41 left in the game. The Boilermakers will take a timeout here. They're trailing by 5. 2:39 left in the game. Risky pass. Give. Swish. He's 3 for 5 for the game. They're going to double team him. Leads him with the pass. Ravello takes it up. This crowd couldn't be any happier. Just listen to the people in this building. And they're now out in front by 5. Give. It's blocked. Milan takes it up. Rips it through with the one-handed. He's got 10. Hamilton inbounds the ball. Ravello takes the shot. He rips down the rebound. Blocked! The Boilermakers, a 3, will tie the game. Melvin goes up, gently drops it in. He's shooting 60% for the game. He's doubled up. Ravello tosses it up court. Bounces it to the left. Stipes goes up. Right in with the D.J. ball over. They're now up by 3. 1:33 left in the game.
Thousand! What a good call.
Harden was needed out on the floor. He didn't get much of a rest. Inbounds the ball. Dickerson has it on the inside. Pass left side. Shoots. Drops it. They're now down by 1. They're bringing the double team. Frazier from the free throw line. He rips down the rebound.
Oh, what great burn. That's the shot you hoped for, but it didn't drop.
Catches it outright. Ravello kicks it out to the perimeter. The last play was passed in by Frazier.
Incredible display of offensive firepower.
It's been this way all game, Bill, and you have to wonder if one of these two teams will eventually run out of gas.
Gibb just picked up his 3rd foul of the game. Melvin didn't sit for long, and he's coming back into the ballgame. Hamilton inbounds the ball. He throws it out of bounds.
A little overexcited on that look, Vern. It takes precision to throw a pass like that. He's just way off target with that one.
25 seconds left in the game.
Foul! Oh, you can't come across the body like that. That is a textbook reach.
Melvin
shoots. He grabs the rebound. He can live with that miss. He's open. He knows that he's going to make it more often than not.
Well, no choice but to foul. They've got to stop the clock and get the ball back right away.
Dickerson has picked up his 1st foul of the game.
I can appreciate their willingness to keep battling, Vern, but I think it's too late to save the game. Fouling isn't going to do them any good anymore.
Ravello inbounds the ball. Frazier releases. Pockets the 3 ball. Now's the time typically when the coach enters the
ball. There's no time to really start his out at this point or risk injury.
Marvel.
There's a pizza.
In the bonus here, so that'll be a 1-1 at the line.
need him back on the floor.
Perfect for the lock. And it's a 9-point ball game.
Dickerson passes way down court.
Harden lets it go. It went in. What a buzzer beater.
That's the game. Ohio State knocks off the Boilermakers 71-65.